Since we built this technology demonstrator for the annular combustor for the GT50 engine, we've made a whole host of improvements across its design. In addition to making the whole thing much easier and more cost-effective to manufacture, we've integrated a whole host of technical refinements that make it work much better. One of the most important features is we've now integrated the HP turbine nozzle guide vane as an integrated welded part of the combustor to make sure that connection is aerodynamically smooth and structurally very, very strong and robust. So we've integrated that. We've also improved the way that we can fit and seal the fuel injection nozzles as they come through the combustor casing into the back of the annular combustor. And we've improved the overall thermomechanical design of this so that it can breathe both axially and radially as it's inside the engine. So with all of those refinements made, we then have to update the manufacturing tools and get on with building the prototype one for the first GT50 engine. Let's go and have a quick look at what we've been doing to do that. So each of the rings of the combustor is made by form rolling strips of high performance nickel alloy. To produce the new rings, we've had to make new sets of tools for each and every one of the inner and the outer rings. Each one of these roll forming tool pairs has then been hardened so that they meet the actual production tool design intent for longevity and reliability. These tools can then be finished machined and get started on rolling the rings on the roll forming machine. While we were developing the forming processes for the original annular combustor, there were lots of areas where the material had been worked slightly too hard, where the surface finish wasn't quite right, where the welding wasn't quite right, lots of little nuanced details that ate away at the quality. With the new processes that have all been refined, you can see that these rings are now really, really well formed. All of the profile detail is in there nicely, and that's true of all of the different rings that go into producing these parts, both for the inner rings and also the range of outer rings that make up the outer side of the annular combustor. And one of the other areas that we've refined significantly is the laser welding processes that we use to join these rolled strips into continuous rings. If you look on the original combustor, these processes took a lot of development to get the consistency and the quality right. And all the welds you can see here are quite scrappy. For the prototype engine, these need to be very, very carefully and consistently executed to deliver parent metal properties in the welds where they join the two sides together. We're at that level now, and we're consistently producing great laser welds that will give these things really high fatigue and static strength in service. So with the new high quality rings rolled and form rolled with the profiles in, the next stage is for them to go onto the expander and to be stretched out to be perfectly round and to the correct size. So we're currently building a whole suite of new pie slice tools so that when we pull this tapered pin down and expand these out, each and every one of them fits perfectly. Let's go and have a look at those. So each one of these sets of pie slice tools starts as a large machined bar that's then faced off on the lathe and then machined to the exact profile that we need for each pie slice. So this one's just had its facing operation on both sides completed, and then tomorrow morning they'll be putting the profile into the edge to match the form of the ring that we wanted exactly the right diameter. Once it's done that, that whole ring is taken over to the wire EDM machine and we'll cut that up into equal pie slices ready to go onto the expander. So the flat rear face of the annular combustor is formed using a pressing process where we take a ring of flat superalloy material and then we produce a male and female press tool that provide the shape that we want to create to accept the fuel injection nozzles, and then we sandwich the sheet metal between the male and female tool and press out the form that we need and then just cut off the excess before it gets welded into the rest of the assembly. So we've now developed all of these press tools. We've made the first pressings. There's still a little bit of process development to do on these, but they're good enough for the prototype engine. You've heard me talk a lot about the extent that we're going to make sure we seal the different parts of the engine properly. And one area where that's really important is the back of the combustor, where we have to bring the fuel manifold in from the outside of the combustor casing through the casing and then seal the fuel nozzle and the swirler itself into each of the 12 ports on the back of the annular combustion liner itself. Now, to do that, what we've got is a floating seal washer that sits around the fuel manifold. And that washer itself is spring-loaded against the back of the combustor casing by these little spring plates that we've had to make here. So one of the other areas that the guys have been working on over the last couple of weeks or so is, again, out of the same super alloy material, to take a flat disc of laser cut or water jet cut material and then to press that out into the three-dimensional form that we need to then weld that onto the back of the combustor, making sure we can seal every single one of the swirlers and every single one of the fuel nozzles exactly where it needs to be. So with all of the manufacturing processes now developed for the latest design features of the new annular combustor for GT50, we're on with producing the test parts for the prototype engine to run later this year.